little town or city where my people lived and died. The howdy and the handshake, the air of feeling free, and the right to speak my mind now. That's America to me. The things I see about me, the big things and the small, the little corner newsstand and the house a mile tall, the wedding and the churchyard, the laughter and the tears, and the dream that's been a-growing for 180 years. The town I live in.
I learned the truth at 17, that love was meant for beauty queens and high school girls with clear-skinned smiles who married young and then retired. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth were spent on one more beautiful. At 17, I learned the truth. And those of us with ravaged faces, lacking in the social graces, desperately remained at home, inventing lovers on the phone, who called and said, "Come dance with me," and murmured vague obscenities. It isn't all it seems.
My favorite teacher was Bob Anderson, our math teacher. Our math class, which was the advanced class, stayed together all 3 years. We had Bob all 3 years. He was remarkably focused, and he was upfront about it. He told us he wanted each of us to score as high as we possibly could on the SAT math test, and he was incredibly, incredibly good at getting us to do just that. He taught with passion. Some of the tricks and techniques that he instilled in us then, I still remember to this day.
Mrs. Brown, you've got a lovely daughter.
The English class assignment was to write a sample, repeat, a sample letter to the editor of the Swampscott magazine. Imagine my surprise when the next issue of the magazine came out and my letter was there in print. Here is the letter, abridged for space. To the editors, I would like to ask a question of the Department of Athletics through the Swampscott. Why is it that the gym is not open to those students who wish to make use of it? Our late president, John F. Kennedy, brought into focus the great importance of physical fitness, but President Kennedy didn't say that only sophomores and juniors should be physically fit. He said that everyone should be physically fit. When I went to the admin office, I was told that Coach Bondarevich wanted to see me immediately. The walk to the gym locker room was not pleasant, and seeing him behind his desk told me that the meeting wasn't going to be pleasant either. I was grilled as to why I thought that I knew how the athletic department should be run. Needless to say, this was my first lesson in making sure that I knew all ramifications of an assignment.
Second verse, same as the first. I'm Henry the Eighth, I am. Henry the Eighth, I am, I am.
I got you, babe. I got you, babe.
Such an easy game to play.
Hey, 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 you, you're out of my cloud. Hey, hey, you, you're out of my cloud.
Baby, whenever you're near, I hear a symphony. Each time you speak to me,
to everything turn, turn, turn. There is a season turn, turn.
Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte, Charlotte, don't you cry. Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte, he'll love you till he dies.
Until you come back and be mine, no matter what. Coffee House, great folk music, that's for sure. Wrapping it up this weekend, Paul Butterfield Blues Band. Then Monday, Hootenanny Night, Monday night.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down.
Une fois, j'avais un arbre, un petit arbre vert. Une fois, il n'y a pas longtemps, j'aimais mon arbre comme j'aimais mon ami. Si gentil, si vivant, trop vert. Aujourd'hui, J'ai un grand arbre encore vert. Mais mon ami, il est mort, couvert de petites feuilles.
We must open opportunity to all our people.
We feel that women will work just as good as men and better.
When the husband is the guy who's in charge and should be all of the time.
The latest threat to the status quo is the women's revolt.
It is a pleading for social change.
Even the fear of imprisonment forces most homosexuals to camouflage their identities.
Let's grow up, conservatives.
The public did not have the whole picture.
What we are talking about is a revolution.
I'll be back in 10 minutes.
There's a time for joy, a time for tears, a time we'll treasure through the years. We'll remember always. Graduation day. At the senior prom, we danced till three, and there you gave your heart to me. We'll remember always. Graduation day. Sorrow, all the joys we've known, we can face tomorrow, knowing we'll never walk alone. When the ivy walks are far beyond, no matter where our paths may wind, we'll remember always graduation day. We'll remember always graduation.
Spend when you get to
child came out to wonder. And caught a dragonfly inside a jar. And fearful when the skies were full of thunder. And the season, they go round and round, painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came and go round and round. And the child moved 10 times round the seasons and skated over 10 clear frozen streams. Words like, when you're older, you must appease him. And promises of some.
It is a mixture of pretty scenery and ugly events.
Vietnam reports today of the bloodiest fighting in almost a year.
We will not surrender, and we will not retreat.
Think you can win?
Oh, I know we can win.
These people are being killed, and they're being killed. Why?
And the person who founded Special Friends was a woman named Joanne Patton. She is the daughter-in-law of General George Patton. And she's married to General George Patton's son, George Patton. She was married. And we became very friendly with them. And they asked us to sing for the 51st anniversary in Normandy for the liberation of France. And it was an incredibly emotional experience. I'm proud to say that I did that because I was against the Vietnamese War.
Life, so they say, is but a game and they let it slip away.
Love, like the autumn sun,
should be dying, but it's only just begun.
Like the twilight in the road up ahead, they don't see just where we're going. And all the secrets in the universe whisper in our ears. All the years come and go, take us up, always up. We may never pass this way again. We may never pass this way.
Say, for the fools and they let them drift away.
Peace, like the silent dove,
should be flying, but it's only just begun.
Like Columbus in the olden days, we must gather all our courage.
Sail our ships out on the open sea.
Cast away our fears.
the challenges came in the beginning of my life, actually starting in high school. I think everyone can believe it, because the more I find out, the more I realize that most of the people I know had challenges in high school and have been able to get through it. If you can get through high school, you can get through life. I had difficult years between the ages of 13 and 21.
And now for some reflections. Over the years, I've come to decide I got an exceptionally good public education at Swampscott High. I felt safe there and at home. I liked the long walk home from school, past the sub shop, stopping, of course, for one loaded with everything, and the football games and the dances and all the intense, angst-ridden conversations teenage kids have. I learned to admire intelligence, integrity, and empathy, especially when kids had certain talents and skills and followed them, regardless of what was in. I also missed some really good opportunities in that regard. And looking back at those years, I wish I'd had a more diverse experience. Our class was pretty homogeneous, but I also realized that I was pretty naive, so I probably missed most of whatever diversity there was.
The greatest success of the 50 years since graduation has been my family. My wife, Penny, and I just celebrated our 40th wedding anniversary. We have two wonderful children. My son, David, is 37. My daughter, Jamie, is 34. They have given us two grandchildren. They give me a sense of fulfillment and wonderment every day. Jamie is going to give me a third grandchild at the very end of September, which is why I won't be able to be with you at the actual reunion.
My